Hello and welcome. Some of you may recognize this screen. And there you have it, the Ur-Quan Masters. This is Let's Play the Ur-Quan Masters. And I am needing to make sure. Okay. The Ur-Quan Masters is, once again, a remake or port of a really great 1990s space adventure based on the source code of Star Control 2. Originally created by Fred Ford and Paul Reich III in 1992. And they released their code to the open source community, so now we have this. Which is basically Star Control 2. Okay, so there were many great battles. Earth and her partners in the Alliance of Free Stars. It's not really important that you played Star Control 1 against the evil Ur-Quan and the hierarchy of battle throwers. And the Ur-Quan were winning. The Star Control 1, meanwhile, the age of the unknown frontier, an amazing discovery was made. Star Control 1 was a very different game to this game. It wasn't as adventure-y. Far beneath the surface of an unexplored alien world. So this is us. A huge underground city was found. And look at it, it's huge. Filled with the technological wonders of an advanced alien race, the Precursors. Who vanished 1,000 centuries ago. Stop me if you've heard this storyline before. This was very original when it came out, but then the main Ur-Quan fleet broke through the Alliance's defensive line, isolating the planet, stranding the scientists 100 light-years away from Earth. Oh no. What did they do? They waited hopefully for a rescue vessel, but did one come? Which never came. Dun dun dun! 20 years have passed. 20 years. We, the survivors of the research mission, have colonized this world. So, Star Control 2. We continued our investigation of the underground city. I should have done all my spiel before I started the intro. And we have discovered its purpose. It is to boldly go where... Oh, it is a factory. Sorry. a factory for building starships. I will be voice acting a lot of this. But there aren't enough materials to make a complete vessel. Oh, no. You don't need me to talk. Okay, you can read the rest of it on your own. So, basically, Star Control 1 was a very different type of game. It was sort of... From what I know of it, and I haven't actually played it that much, but it was almost a real-time strategy game, but level-based. And you would go out... Actually, it was more like almost more like a Masters of Orion. You would go out and colonize worlds and make resources and create ships and then go out and destroy the enemy. I think that's what it was like. This game is completely not like that. This game... If you've never played Star Control 2, you need to look up the Ur-Quan Masters. I think it's SC2 at sourceforge.com these days. And it's an amazing game. Just check it out because it's a real... It's once again, this is one of the games that got me into gaming. Like, between this and Wing Commander, I was set on my path, really. So here we are, we've made it to Sol Sector, it's not a sector, is it? Oh no. By default, we're called Captain Zelnik in the Vindicator, you'll see on the top right, you know, with the 10 fuel units, we've got an Earthling cruiser next to us, and a crew of 50, which is not much at all. One thing you should know, the Ur-Quan Masters, it's actually, a hybrid, I say, and, of the PC version of Star Control 2 and also the 3DO version, which not a lot of people played but had a lot of improvements, including fully voiced acting. I don't know if I've got that set up here, but hopefully I don't, because I don't really want, like, the voices are great and all, but I would like to skip past a lot of it, and it's just awkward if they're talking in the middle of that. So what do I want? I want to go to games and settings and just change the captain's name to Shepherd, is that how you spell it? Shepherd, whatever, of the flagship Normandy for no, absolutely no reason at all. And then we can go and navigate. So our first destination obviously is to recontact with the peoples of Earth and find out what's going on there. Now, obviously this is not a blind let's play. I've played this game many, many a time before. I've only completed it once, but I know so much about it. Oh shit. See, the thing is, one of the things that I love about this game, but it's frustrating to begin with, is that you've got an upgradable ship, and as you can see, my turning circle is horrible, and I'm actually going pretty slow. Oh no, something's coming for us. Oh god.
Heed this recorded message.
With the voice and authority of the Ur-Quan.
You are trespassing within Ur-Quan space.
Ur-Quan space.
This world, Earth, may not.
So this is just a probe. It's not dangerous. Nor will excuse the noise as I move my microphone.
In addition, your ship does not respond.
See, this is the voice acting in this game. I don't know if you can hear it. I might have my volume down too low.
That's right, we are independent.
Oh, really? Isn't it? Why not? Subservience? What are you talking about?
Grown now leaves to inform the Ur-Quan.
To remain here and await the arrival of the Ur-Quan.
Disobedience will be punished.
Alright, so that's your basic setup. There was a whole story in the manual about, but it was about the start of the wars and the whole reason, like going into space and all that. It had nothing to do with the backstory of this game, which is elegantly told in the cutscene we saw earlier. So really, the first time you play this game, you're not going to know what to do. Oh my god, what happened to Earth? There is a giant red shield all over it. So we can't do anything here. So let's check out the space station. So you're not really going to have much guidance.
Attention, unidentified space vessel.
Oh, hello.
Starbase Commander Hayes of the Slug.
Hello, Mr. Hayes. Commander Hayes, sorry.
Our hyperwave broadcast.
Extremely weak. Oh, no.
Situation critical. Energy cores exhausted. Scanners and deep radar are non-functional.
No.
We cannot identify.
What can I do?
Vessel.
Can I help you?
Are you the scheduled hierarchy resupply ship?
Are we? No, we're not.
Are you the resupply vessel?
No, this is a starship Normandy, but we stand ready to assist you. Slave planet? Hierarchy resupply vessel? What is going on here? Actually, I like that one.
I don't know who you are or why you're here. Right now, the only thing I'm worried about is saving the lives of 1,900 men and women aboard this starbase.
Okay, okay, we'll go and find the elements. He needs us to find some radioactive elements. So we're going to go out and look out in the solar system and see if we can grab something that he can use. And unfortunately, my knowledge of the game is sort of... I can't ignore my knowledge of the game. So as I said, this is not a blind let's play, but I'm going to try and present it to you as blindly as possible. Just auto-scan. And so there we have some minerals, and we can see from the statistics this place has a temperature of 165 on average, so it's quite hot, as you would expect Mercury to be. We've got level 3 earthquakes. That's the jaggy line there on the bottom left. So we can send down a lander, a Mako, and it actually pulls crew out of your ship. To do this, so if you get fried, then your crew is gonna go down. So this is one of the ways that I could lose the game very early on, as is traditional for me. Also notice that you will not land exactly where you point that pointer at there. So
There's some nice addition. Whoa. Fuck me. Alright. My lander's cargo hold is tiny, so we've got to make a couple of trips down here. But we've probably got enough radioactives. The ones we want, I don't think it actually matters. I think it's, you know, it's up to you how much you... Oh, God! We just lost half the crew. Let's get out of here. And just clean up. So, that will be... I'm going to stop the video here, and next time on Let's Play the Ur-Quan Masters, we'll return our goods back to the planet, the Earth Starbase. Alright.